Hello, brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, and pre-Christians, and rebellious, unrepentant sinners, whoever sees this video. I'm going to read not a whole book today. I am going to read, as I stated earlier, I think I said it in the Ephesians video. I can't remember if I did or not. I remember saying it somewhere. It was either in typing or speaking, that I was going to read Ephesians, but from the Wuest translation, which I really love the way he translates the Greek. He was a Kenneth Wuest. He was a Greek scholar, and he was one of the original translators of the New American Standard Bible. He had passed away, I think it was in 1961 or 62 or something, and the first translator started working on the New American Standard Bible in 1960. So he was one of those translators then. And he had actually translated his own New Testament from the Greek, and he's a real wordsmith, I think the term is. He really has a way of bringing out the meaning of the words, like how the Amplified does. But his is, it's really special, I think. It used to be really popular. I heard about Bobby Connor speaking about how you had to get out the Wuest, and Curry Blake likes the Wuest too. It's called Wuest Expanded Translation of the New Testament. I had found it a long time ago. Actually, it was because of Curry Blake, listening to him preach and mention it. And I looked into it, and I just love it. My mom likes it, too. Actually, I think I have a printed copy. I gave it to her, though. Now I just have it on digital, and I purchased that through different sites for my sword. I translated it from, or I converted it from the module that I purchased for it from eSword. eSword is a application that you can have on iPhone or on PC. I had it on PC and I purchased it through my eSword resources company or whatever, he's the guy who made eSword. It's a Bible app which you can have books and dictionaries and different Bible translations and all kinds of things, maps. It's a really cool application. And mySword is equivalent to that, but it's for Android. I also have eSword for my iPhone. I have the Wuest in that as well, because I purchased it from, I think I do. I can't remember if I do or not. But anyway, so that's the story of this translation. So I'm just going to read Ephesians chapter 1 and the first part of Ephesians chapter 2. I won't read the whole book. And then tomorrow, I think I'm going to go into some Psalms. My mom sent an email suggesting a few that I'm going to do to honor her suggestion. Three of them. I'll just do a short video on three Psalms tomorrow. But right now, it is just Wuest, Ephesians 1, and the first part of 2. So, let's begin. Ephesians 1. Paul, an ambassador of Christ Jesus, through the will of God, to the saints, the ones who are in Ephesus, namely, believing ones in Christ Jesus. Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. So I just want to preface this reading here from the chapter or verse 3 through 14. It's one long sentence. There's no periods. This is the longest sentence, I think, in the world. It's amazing, though. Okay, get ready and listen. May the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ be eulogized, the one who conferred benefactions upon us in the sphere of every spiritual blessing in the heavenly places in Christ, even as he selected us out for himself in him before the foundations of the universe were laid, to be holy ones and without blemish before his searching, penetrating gaze, in love, having previously marked us out to be placed as adult sons through the intermediate agency of Jesus Christ for himself, according to that which seemed good in his heart's desire, resulting in praise of the glory of his grace, which he freely bestowed upon us in the Beloved, in whom we are having our redemption through his blood, the putting away of our trespasses, according to the wealth of his grace, which he caused to superabound to us in the sphere of every wisdom and understanding, having made known to us the mystery of his will according to that which seemed good to him, which good thing he purposed in himself, with respect to an administration of the completion of the epochs of time, to bring back again to their original state all things in the Christ, the things in the heavens and the things on the earth, in him, in whom also were made, also we were made an inheritance, having been previously marked out according to the purpose of the one who operates all things according to the counsel of his will, with a view to our being to the praise of his glory, who had previously placed our hope in the Christ, in whom also, as for you, having heard the word of the truth, the good news of your salvation, in whom also having believed, you were sealed with the Spirit of the promise, the Holy Spirit, who is the token payment of our inheritance, guaranteeing the full payment of all, looking forward to the redemption of the possession which is being preserved with a view to the praise of his glory. So I'll just mention how that's one sentence. Isn't that amazing? I just love it. Yeah. So I'll continue. On account of this, I also have heard of the faith in the Lord Jesus which is among you, and of your love to all the saints. Do not cease giving thanks for you, as I constantly make mention of you in my prayers, that the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, might give to you a spirit of wisdom and revelation in the sphere of a full knowledge of him, the eyes of your heart being in an enlightened state, with a view to you knowing what is the hope of his calling, what is the wealth of the glory of his inheritance in the saints, and what is the superabounding greatness of his inherent power to us who are believing ones, as measured by the operative energy of the manifested strength of his might, which might was operative in the Christ when he raised him from above, or raised him from among the dead, and seated him at his right hand in the heavenly places, over and above every government and authority and power and lordship and every name that is constantly being named, not only in this age, but also in the one about to come. And all things he put in subjection under his feet, and him he gave as head over all things to the church, which is of such a nature as to be his body, the fullness of the one who constantly is filling all things with all things. Ephesians chapter 2, the first part. And you being dead with reference to your trespasses and sins, he made alive in the sphere of which trespasses and sins, at one time you ordered your behavior as dominated by the spirit of the age, in this world system, as dominated by the leader of the authority of the lower atmosphere, the source also of the spirit that is now operating in the sons of the disobedience, among whom also we all ordered our behavior in the sphere of the cravings of our evil nature, continually practicing the desire of our evil nature and of our thoughts, and were continually children of wrath by nature, as also the rest. But God, being wealthy in the sphere of mercy, because of his great love with which he loved us, and we, being dead with respect to our trespasses, made us alive together with the Christ. By grace you have been saved completely in past time, with the present result that you are in a state of salvation which persists through present time, and raised us up, or raised us with him, and seated us with him in the heavenly places in Christ Jesus, in order that he might exhibit for his own glory in the ages that will pile themselves one upon another in continuous succession, the surpassing wealth of his grace in kindness to us in Christ Jesus. For by the grace have you been saved in time past completely through faith, with the result that your salvation persists through present time, and this salvation is not from you as a source. Of God it is the gift, not from a source of works, in order that no one might boast. For we are his workmen, or his handiwork, created in Christ Jesus with a view to good works, which God prepared beforehand, in order that within their sphere we may order our behavior. So there, I finish there, just to the end of verse 10, Ephesians 2. So yeah, isn't that wonderful? I just love the way he uses the English language to translate the Greek to the English language with such skill. And I don't know, it's just really cool. I think he suggests that you don't use that as your primary Bible, because he's just one man who's translating a work from the Greek text to English. Maybe he, out of integrity, wants that you should have other Bibles that are translated with a group of men, probably women too, that are led by the Spirit in translating the actual original languages, either Hebrew, Aramaic, or Greek. And then they come to a consensus as to what the English should say. So it's best, I think, probably to have those types of Bibles as your primary source of reading for the Word of God, like the NASB, which is supposed to be one of the most accurate translations. It uses the more accurate, the codexes or whatever, the ones that they've found that are, I think they're older than the Textus Receptus, which was used for the King James Version, and the New King James Version, and I think there's others that use that too, but the older manuscripts, that's the word I was trying to think, not codex, but manuscripts, they found, I guess, that were older than the ones for the Textus Receptus, and they believe that they're more accurate. So NASB is supposed to be the most accurate translation. I don't like it as much as the New King James Version. That's my favorite. King James Version, I like it. I like it a lot. It's just that I don't like the Old English. A lot of the words, I don't want to have to look up something that I don't understand because it's Old English. It's not in today's language. So I like the New King James Version for that. And so I'm not one of those King James Bible only people. That's like I think that's kind of like cultic. It's crazy because it's English. It's not something that the original writers of the books, like the Old Testament books, like Moses and all the others after him, and then the New Testament writers for the Gospels and Epistles, and they didn't use English as their language. It was Greek, Aramaic, or Hebrew. Anyway, if you want to be really accurate, then just learn Greek, Aramaic, or Hebrew and read it in the original texts, and read multiple texts and listen to the Holy Spirit. You need the Holy Spirit to understand the Bible anyway. So this is another hat. It's Frontier Alliance International, FAI. I wanted this color, but it's where it says Frontier Alliance International. They were out of those. It's a trucker cap, you know, where it's got the mesh. So it's good for summer. I like wearing caps because my hair is like leaving my head. But in Jesus' name, it is growing back. Be healed. And today, I did make a drink. It's just coffee. Drip from the drip. And it's my older, my more used Ballads of the Revelation cup. It's like peeling off. Anyway, so that's my shorter video. What's the time? I don't even know. It's 13, 15 minutes? I should end it here. So again, if you need any help for healing or deliverance, or you want to know Jesus, you want to know about the Lord, you want to be filled with the Holy Spirit, you want to, if you live in my area, I'm in Winnipeg, and you want baptism, you want to be baptized underwater, like full submersion, if you want to meet and hang out, commune with one another, if you want to, I'm going to start going out more often and praying for the sick, and being fruitful in that, and feeding the hungry, and clothing the naked, and doing the things that Jesus commands us as disciples to do. If you need any help, or you have any questions, reach out to me at my short URL, lovesflame.com. I have it forwarding to the main website that I use for blogging, a most vehement flame. org, and there is a contact tab and about tab and Kingdom 101 was training, with DHT training, a whole bunch of like MP3s and videos you can watch or download and listen to, and there's a Who Is Jesus Really tab, talks about Jesus Christ, and that links to another website that I thought was really comprehensive, and a subscribe tab where you can subscribe to the emails to get updates when I do updates to that website, and I'm doing that pretty frequently right now. People who are subscribed maybe are getting sick of my emails, but it's pretty much every day lately when I've started doing the Bible scripture reading. Yeah, I'm going longer. I'll just keep going till it's like 20 minutes or so. But or if you need also on that those tabs, what else is there? Is a support. Partner support tab. So if you want to support my ministry, Vehement Flame Ministries. I started that in 2012. Actually, I wanted to start it before that, but then on my mostvehementflame.org website, I saw someone doing a search from Google, because I used to get the Google search results, and someone was searching for Vehement Flame Ministries. And I thought, someone's going to try and use that name. And it turned out actually someone was trying to use that name. So right away I started Vehement Flame Ministries and Vehement Flame Ministries International. And that person who tried to start it using his name, he used Vehement Flame Global Ministries or something like that. I don't think he's... anyway, I won't talk about that. But yeah. Anyway... also there's a home tab, obviously, that lists all of the blog posts. I would like to make a new website, but I'll have to do that at some other point when I have more time. After I'm done scripture reading, I'm going to focus on the scripture reading and being faithful with going out to spread the gospel, pray for the sick, and feed the hungry, and that sort of thing. And so reach out to me if you want. If not, God bless you all. Grace, peace, and love in Jesus Christ. Okay, bye-bye.